हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम टू एक बूंद सोच की टी टॉक ट्रेन ऑफ थॉट्स। दिस प्लेटफॉर्म लाइक वी ट्राई एंड इनवाइट द प्रोमिनेंट पर्सनालिटीज फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री, लेट बी टॉक इन टर्म्स ऑफ एन लीडरशिप, एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप और एन स्ट्रगल स्टोरी और ए यंग अचीवर अवार्ड। सो दिस इज़ अ प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर लाइक इट्स बेसिकली व्हेन वी टॉक इन टर्म्स ऑफ एन टी टॉक, it's a community of friends who are there sharing their experience with the others so that they draw some learning out of it. Today on this platform we are having Mr. Ajay Rawal. So welcome to TeaTalk platform. Mr. Ajay Rawal is a professional with a unique combination of RX, OTC and FMCG sales marketing knowledge. He has got experience in operating in the private equity environment and also credible knowledge in nurturing and growing the iconic brand of Indian and the multinationals company. Some of the brand to name a few, sir, it's Move, Itchguard, Tiger Balm, Crack, Decode and Kama Sutra. And he has been instrumental in conceptualizing, guiding and executing the key marketing intervention to increase the top line and bottom line of an organization's. And he is very good into the management skills to drive the change. And he is heading the global marketing function. And also he is a keynote speaker on the various seminar and the conferences. So on this TikTok platform, today we are having Mr. Ajay Rawal with us. We'll try and share his story with the audience so that we draw some meaningful learning. Mr. Ajay Rawal, welcome to TikTok platform.
Thank you very much, Dr. Chima, and I am indeed grateful that I am able to grace this valuable platform of yours. Before I begin any of my sessions, generally, sir, I like to enumerate the Shanti Mantra. So, with sure. your kind permission, if sir, please, I may do please, so, because in all these tough times, we all require a bit of peace. Yeah. So, the Shanti Mantra is religion agnostic. It's in Sanskrit. Yeah. It goes like this. ओम सहना ववतु सहनो भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहे तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहे ओम शांतिः शांतिः शांतिः. What it means is that may the divine grace nourish us, may the divine grace protect us, may together we perform the right karma, may the new learning lead to enlightenment. Om, let there be peace on the earth, let there be peace in you and me, let there be peace in the whole universe.
So nice.
So peace to all of the audiences and the viewers of Tea Talk, and I'll try to add whatever best value I can to the best of my ability over my years of experience with people and with organizations. Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks a lot for spending your valuable time with us, sir. On Tea Talk platform, would like to know your journey during the education days, how you have started your career. So can you throw some light on that?
Sir, I hail from a humble background from Dehradun. Mm-hmm. My father worked with ONGC, and our home was very near the Indian Military Academy at Dehradun. Mm-hmm. So I completed my schooling from St. Joseph's Academy, one of the best known centrally located schools at Dehradun. And post that, I did my graduation, and it is by serendipity that I happened to, be at Allahabad for SSB, my first ever endeavor. People from Dehradun generally, look at the armed forces as one of the key professions, because IMA was 3 kilometers from our home. Mm-hmm. And hence, in the first attempt at SSB, of course, I cleared the CDS. And when I was at Allahabad for my first attempt at SSB, I could not clear it. Mm-hmm. And I was returning back home. I was at Lucknow, where my mama said that, Lupin is a very good pharmaceutical company and it's recruiting people. Why don't you just, go and have an interview? Mm-hmm. So I was fortunate enough. They selected me and then they sent me to Mumbai for a month of training. Mm-hmm. And then I was posted at a place which today people would have heard from a web series. Mm-hmm. The place is called Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh.
Okay.
So that was the initiation of my career.
Sir, uske pehla maybe Lupin ke pehla kuch jab bhi bachpan mein har ek ichha hoti na, jab teacher poochte ab kya banoge, to aap mein kuch aisa tha like you want to become X, Y, Z in your career?
यस, सबसे पहला जो डिज़ायर था वॉज टू बिकम अ फाइटर पायलट.
ओके.
बट एज वॉट हैपन्स इज दैट यू नो इन अ कंट्री लाइक इंडिया नॉट एवरी वन इज able to pursue their childhood dreams because mm-hmm. of a variety of reasons
mm-hmm.
and sometimes life takes us in a direction which we may not know
mm-hmm.
and we may realize and discover what is it that we like doing
mm-hmm.
and the important thing is that until and unless you are doing what you love doing
mm-hmm.
it's not going to work out.
It's not going to work out.
So I generally say there are three things that are very very critical in life, you know. First, life is meant to be unfair.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We see fairness happening only in movies and serials.
Correct, correct.
Right? Actually, everything becomes normal within 2 hours in a movie
correct.
Or in half an hour in a television mm-hmm. serial. In reality, life doesn't function like that.
Mm-hmm.
Life is tough.
Correct.
So life is meant to be unfair. You know, mm-hmm. we grow up believing everything is going to be hunky-dory.
Correct.
Second, you have to enjoy what you do to earn a living.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not doing that, you can't do it for long, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
And so, third, you have to learn to let go, because people, situations are never going to be as per your liking. You have to fight your way through.
It's not in your hand.
It's not in your hand, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me how many things you have in your control, whereas our entire life we are trying to control someone or something or situations.
Correct. It's not in your control at all, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. So now, in fact, maybe when we say your first love, that's what, like, once we enter into a loop in, what was an experience like, you know?
So, you know, what's very important even for all the students is that to understand the basic sales function.
Mm-hmm.
You know, how is it that the actual consumer who buys your product,
mm-hmm.
why he or she buys your product?
Mm-hmm.
So Lupin was a prescription kind of a nature of business in terms mm-hmm. of sales.
Correct.
When it comes to OTC, it is direct to consumer.
Correct.
Or in FMCG, it's direct to consumer.
Yeah.
So I learned how to influence or how to build relationship with the doctors
mm-hmm.
so that they value my company's product and prescribe it to more and more patients that come to them.
Okay.
Though it is not a direct interaction with the patient, but it is a direct interaction with the influencer.
Okay.
When the company's name, the product quality, that has to speak for itself.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, what kind of relationship do you build with them at an ethical level is what is very important.
So what was the tenure in Lupin like overall?
I almost worked for three years. And then I realized, can I do something better? Because when I saw product managers coming in our quarterly sales meeting,
yeah.
I checked with them. I said that, you know, how can I become a product manager?
Okay.
So, you know, sir, at that time, one of the key desires or my key aim or key goal in life is that I wanted to see myself working as a product manager.
Okay.
I thought at that time, if I become a product manager, I think life will be sorted. That will be the biggest ever goal that, I could. Coming from starting as a medical representative to being a product manager based out of Mumbai, you know, there can't be a bigger or a better goal.
Correct.
So I think that was the goal for me at that time.
Okay. So I think many a time if you talk in terms of today's students, like first thing, if they want to make their career in marketing, they will say, I would like to get into a brand, branding. So first concept which comes in their mind is then brand development. But ideally, I think actually if you talk in terms of getting into that product management or into the branding, first thing is that you need to understand your customers. You need to build up a relationship at the bottom end.
Absolutely.
Then only I think works for one. Like, since you did your MBA and then you did your BSc, and always you wanted to get into the pharma, or why not other sector? Like,
well, sir, in 90s, if I would be very honest with you, the opportunities that were available were pretty restricted in the country.
Okay.
So certain things happened by serendipity.
Mm-hmm.
And certain things, you know, we design for ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
But at that time, I kind of, cherished understanding how sales really happens.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I realized that, you know, probably I have a better opportunity because, you know, when I would communicate with others, you know, they'll receive it well. So I checked with product managers that, you know, how can I get into marketing? They said, you're doing well, take a promotion and continue doing your creative work. The company might give you an opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
But I said, you know, and that's what vision is all about, that, you know, we always think. I said, you know, in future, getting into marketing, an MBA would be a mandatory qualification. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's where I decided to pursue my MBA.
MBA, sir.
And that obviously gave me a significant understanding of what I was studying, I could apply to what I had done already.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And hence the appreciation of the processes, the appreciation of the subjects, mm-hmm. and how I would be able to apply them in future became mm-hmm. very, very profound.
Okay. Now, in fact, since you started where you're very focused in terms of that you want to get into the relationship basis. Now, the big leap off and jump, maybe in a span of 20 years, plus your work in a different organization, you leap right from Lupin to Camlin to Ipca to Novartis to Elder Pharmaceuticals and to Paras Pharmaceuticals and to Raymond's. And today, I think you are at the top of a pyramid as in brand management aspects. So would you like to share something about that with the audience?
This is a very interesting question, sir. And let me refer to chapter 3, verse 27 of Bhagavad Gita.
Mm-hmm.
The shloka says, Prakrite kriyamanani guno karmani sarvashah, ahankar vimudatma karta hamitti manyate.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever is happening according to the three modes of material nature, mm-hmm. which is your goodness, your passion, and your ignorance.
Mm-hmm.
But a person overridden by ego thinks that he is the doer.
Mm-hmm.
I would really not say that, you know, I have deliberately, you know, driven a quest to be where I have reached.
Mm-hmm.
I have only put in efforts with reasonable knowledge to appreciate where do I stand, what mm-hmm. are my core strengths,
mm-hmm.
what are my weaknesses, and what are the nature of businesses I will cherish doing,
mm-hmm.
and what I would not really, you know, like. So I have followed my heart.
Mm-hmm.
I have followed my passion.
Mm-hmm.
So goodness, passion, and ignorance.
Okay.
When ignorance is profound, we take wrong decisions.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I have tried to follow. Yeah, there have been wrong decisions in my life as well.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing, you know, some of the organization that I joined, I realized, you know, it's like after marriage only you realize the reality. So
okay.
Some of the organization that I joined did not have a great, you know, tenure or the right thing which I would have cherished.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, if you are good at something,
mm-hmm.
The universe paves the way for you.
Correct.
So I, my major stint in marketing with Ipca, I learned the basics of marketing.
Mm-hmm.
So here the benefit was that, you know, I was launching the product which the sales force is going to sell to the doctors.
Mm-hmm.
My work was to ensure that they become effective in their job.
Correct.
Right. So whatever strategies, inputs I would devise,
mm-hmm.
they have to be they become easy for those people to mm-hmm. implement at the ground level.
Okay.
Then subsequently, I got this opportunity with Novartis.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, 3 years with Ipca, I said, you know, there's a reasonable learning.
Mm-hmm.
And I also believe that the first half of your career,
mm-hmm.
you have to invest into the width and depth of learning.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what you love doing has to be identified.
Correct.
And then the width, how much different areas can you
explore
and what is the depth in each area?
Mm-hmm.
So that depth understanding is very, very critical.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Right. Unfortunately, a lot of things rely at superficial level and
mm-hmm.
we do not go into the depth of understanding those.
Mm-hmm.
But a true professional in the first half of her career will not focus on a monetary, you know, considerations, because
mm-hmm.
money should never be the criteria in first half of career.
Okay.
Money should only be considered in second half of career if you have become valuable in the first half by your width and depth of learning.
Mm-hmm.
And when in the first half of your career, the salary may rise as arithmetic progression.
Correct.
You know, you might look at my colleague or my classmate has really progressed further. His package is probably double of mine, and then, you know, you feel sad about it. But
mm-hmm.
but you know, that could be a short term endeavor.
Mm-hmm.
In the first half of your career, the salary may grow at arithmetic progression.
Mm-hmm.
But in second half, if you have done well with your width and depth of learning, it will
mm-hmm.
grow at geometric progression.
Yeah. Okay.
And that's what we don't recognize. And
mm-hmm.
we see, you have to invest to build your value.
Yeah, correct. Invest time and everything.
Right.
That,
so, therefore, I was fortunate enough, I would say, by God's grace that, you know, I transgressed from prescription sales to prescription marketing, and then I got this opportunity with OTC marketing with Novartis, where I could launch, you know, new brands, and then the subsequent path really progressed to FMCG, you know, for me.
I think it's very interesting for all the youngsters out over there who are doing your MBA, and even the people who are working within an organization. If you need to scale up, like how Mr. Ajay Rawal, he entered into an Lupin as an maybe medical sales rep, like from there, how it grown to Raymond's at the top position at the strategic level. It's that one thing what we have recollected, that it's an uncertain world. First of all, we need to accept that uncertainties are going to be, and it's a part of a business and it's part of a life that you cannot get away from that. But normally, the mantra which like what we could recollect from here, don't chase the money. If you chase the money, I think you are something which you are missing. It's always trying to have an in-depth experience, gain as much as experience you can going in-depth. And secondly, I think what rightly you have said in terms of you should love the work which you are doing.
Absolutely.
Like, agar ishq hai toh, I think the things are different. You never feel like you are tired or you are working, like.
Correct.
So it was an real good insights what like normally it's we got for a target audience. Now, being with a marketing background, what are the assignments and the achievements which gave you the maximum satisfaction?
Would you want to look at them?
We will look in general. We'll just have a glance of that.
Yes.
And
yes,
then we'll get into the achievements and the assignments.
My key achievements, if I may enumerate, you know, what happens is in a career span that lasts about till the age of 60, generally, you get only 4 or 5 major opportunities to do full-fledged things, like say launching a brand, getting an opportunity to launch a brand from the scratch and doing everything to make it successful. That's a full, you know, learning cycle. It doesn't happen every year in every organization. Right. So for me, a couple of major things that happened in my career is, you know, creation of Calcium Sandoz Women.
Okay.
This was a brand that I proposed while I was working with Novartis, where we had a brand like Calcium Sandoz. Now, and you know, this is the first prototype that I've still preserved with me. Now, this is almost like 15 years back.
Oh, I see. Good. How did that thing came in your mind, that innovative
so,
thing?
So, we had this brand Calcium Sandoz, and I said, you know, there is no brand in India which is for calcium for women in the country. So, calcium basically is required by children and for women. There were a lot of prescription brands, but there was none in the consumer domain.
Okay.
So, that's when I proposed that we could, you know, launch this product, and this gave a significant visibility, and it was easily visible in a chemist shelf, because what happens is today when brands are competing vying for consumers' attention, creating a packaging which stands out without paying for the window display, because you know that's an incremental cost, obviously. So this assuaged that possibility. You know, wherever the pack was kept, it was you know, very clearly identifiable by the target audience, and very clearly, because of women require calcium post menopause, you know, every woman requires calcium. So it is clearly positioned, no ambiguity, you know.
It's an excellent thought process which went behind, like, you know, how the packaging should look like or which can appeal to the target consumers. So I think it's a great initiative, sir. Like, it was really great.
Thank you. Next, when I was working with Paras Pharmaceutical, Paras is, you know, was the benchmark company in OTC. At that time, I joined Paras in 2008, and Actis, the private equity firm, had taken the controlling stake, and they were recruiting the professional managers. So the whole task there was, you know, in 3 to 5 years time, we would sell off the company, and therefore the endeavor was to grow the business disproportionately. So I got, you know, probably as we say, you know, right time at the right place, but I was thinking of it. In fact, if I may share with all the, you know, viewers here, when I was in Novartis in the year, say, early 2000s, and when I saw Paras Pharma brands being advertised on television, whether it was Move, whether it was Crack, whether it was Itchguard, Ringguard, Setwet, I said, you know, one day I should get an opportunity to work with this company.
Mm-hmm.
That was a desire, a thought that I just released in the universe.
Mm-hmm.
I never knew how that will happen.
Oh, that will happen. Okay.
And I think that is the secret of goal achievement.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a very, very clear desire, the universe will ensure it will create situations, circumstances to enable you to achieve that.
Correct. Maybe according to you, how important is for the aspiring marketer, like, you know, to understand the connect between the brand management strategy and your goal of and management, like? So connect between three, like, you know, brand management strategies and overall goal of and
so management. I would say, you know, let's funnel it down.
Mm-hmm.
Goal, strategy and brand management, how they stack up.
Mm-hmm.
Right. To give you an example, suppose we need to go from Mumbai to Pune.
Mm-hmm.
So our objective, obviously, or the goal is to reach Pune.
Yeah, right.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
The strategy is which road do we take?
Mm-hmm.
Whether we take the expressway or whether we take the other roads which are there. And then the tactic is what really should we drive by own car.
Mm-hmm.
Or we should we take a bus or we take a train or, you know, aeroplane or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it's very on a similar platform. What is the goal for a marketeer? Incidentally, in every organization, the goal is defined as a particular number.
Yeah.
Okay, we are at 500 crores. Next year goal should be 600 crores.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But if we really think deeply, what enables achievement of that goal?
Mm-hmm.
And is that should be the pursuable goal, the goal that we are pursuing?
Mm-hmm.
Or there is a possibility of defining it in a particular, in an alternative way, which I call it the success formula.
Mm-hmm.
And this goal to me, honestly, is penetration multiplied by consumption.
Okay, penetration multiplied by consumption.
Penetration means how many people are using your brand.
Mm-hmm.
And consumption means how many times in a year they purchase your brand.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. So, like, say, when I was in Paris, I launched this, you know, I had a tie-up with the Rajasthan Royals.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in one of the IPL, and I shot a film with Shane Warne.
Achha.
And this, the sales of Move Spray.
Yeah.
In after airing that film, actually jumped 3 times.
Oh.
What does that mean? That meant that 4 times more number of people probably, or 3 times more number of people have considered buying the brand.
Buying the brand, as
and if they are consuming it regularly, you know, one pack gets over, I go back and buy the same
buy
brand.
The same brand again.
Now numbers are an outcome of it.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
The sales, which increased by you know, quadrupled in that year.
Mm-hmm.
Is actually the goal that we envisage. Okay, we had a particular number, but we never thought that that number could be exceeded.
Mm-hmm.
But there was a clarity that where are we wanting to reach?
Okay.
So therefore, the definition of a goal is, to me, is how many people buy my brand.
Mm-hmm.
And how frequently do they consume? Because no company can build a brand by just, you know, making a consumer buy the brand once.
Correct.
Unless there is repeat purchases.
Repeat purchases. You
know, no brand can become.
It won't serve the purpose.
Until unless it's a FMCD brand where, you know, you buy a car only once in 5 years or 10 years. So on and so forth.
I think in this first episode, we got a great insight from Mr. Ajay Rawal, how he started his career with Lupin and as an head of in Raymond's as an head of marketing. And then interesting story, like normally what we have gathered from him, like saying that the problems are going to is a part of a life, part and parcel of a life. That's what philosophy of Tea Talk is all about. So we need to be more consistent, and we need to go in depth and have an in-depth knowledge of the subject matter, and you should love what you are doing. I think it was a very inspiring episode what we had sir with you. Please go to www.teatalk.net, subscribe and share. So do tune for our next episode with Mr. Ajay Rawal shortly. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you,
thank
sir,
you
for
sir.
Being part of this.
So kind of
thank you very much.